The scruffy hill country outside Austin, Texas was a dirt poor region so isolated it had no electricity or running water. It was home to Lyndon Baines Johnson, a young Texan who wanted to do big things with his life. And from early on, he had a deep and genuine compassion for the poor and the oppressed.
When I was a young man, I taught in a Mexican-American school. And there I got my real deep first impressions of the prejudices that existed and the inequity of our school system between whites and brown.
Lyndon Johnson was born to be a politician. He was 29 when he was first elected to Congress. During the next 10 years, he got the government to help finance slum clearance projects and low-cost housing. Money he got for the region helped farmers go from horse and plow farming to 20th century machinery. And he brought electricity to the hill country.
Write your uncles and your cousins and your aunts and ask them to join you in electing Lyndon Johnson to the Senate.
After 12 years in the U.S. Senate, in 1961, Johnson became John F. Kennedy's vice president. And in 1963, following Kennedy's assassination, Lyndon Johnson became the nation's 36th president.
My fellow Americans, all I have, I would have given gladly not to be standing here today.
Johnson was grief-stricken by Kennedy's death, but he now had the opportunity all his life had prepared him for. Determined to address poverty as no president ever had before, he launched a visionary program he called the Great Society.
I want to be the president who helped the poor to find their own way, who helped to feed the hungry, and who protected the right of every citizen to vote in every election.
President Johnson believed that the government had an obligation to uplift ordinary citizens. He himself had grown up quite poor in Texas, and he really felt that poverty itself was a limitation on people's freedoms. And he said very explicitly that there are many freedoms out there which the government really needs to encourage: freedom of education, freedom of employment, freedom of opportunity in all sorts of ways. So if you are desperately poor, you simply lack the ability to make choices, to pursue opportunities, and that is in itself a violation of your freedom.
Democratic processes was demonstrated in the United States as the Republicans and the Democrats.
Johnson was elected president in his own right in 1964, receiving the highest ever percentage of the popular vote.
The Constitution of the United States.
So help you God.
Working closely with the Democratic Congress, he was able to get an extraordinary array of legislation passed. His Great Society programs benefited poor children, the jobless, and the elderly. But fighting poverty was expensive, and during the 60s, something else began competing for federal funds. It was a war in Southeast Asia, the war in Vietnam.